guys, this is Jesse from itschromeos.com. In this video, we'll be looking at some remote desktop clients available for both Android and Chrome and Chrome OS. So without further ado, let's dive right into it. First on the list is TeamViewer. TeamViewer is a well-known remote desktop application and has been in development for a pretty good while. And you cannot underestimate the undeniable importance of from being able to remote desktop into someone's system remotely, especially as an IT specialist. And the installation procedure for TeamViewer is pretty straightforward, especially if you're on Chromebook. It's basically accessible from two repositories, from the web store as well as from the Play Store. And you also have a quick support Play Store companion app. So basically these two go together in case that you need to install the Android variant. We will leave the link to the written instruction down in the description as well. So you can easily download that, and it installs this application as a web app if you decide to install it via the web store, and it saves you the hassle of having to install an extra app like the Android app requires. But you might find yourself in a situation where you prefer to use the Android app, and if that is the case, by all means. The other option is the one that comes natively, that is made available natively for Chrome OS, which is the Chrome Remote Desktop by Google. Okay, that basically triggered automatically. I didn't even ask it. But anyway, the Chrome Remote Desktop has always been the default for Chrome related use cases. But now it's also the standard for Chromebooks, Chrome boxes, and every other Chrome device that runs the Chrome operating system. So it has become quite ubiquitous just by becoming an added accessory for Chromebooks. And its use case spans across typical school use cases as well as individuals and businesses. So that is to say, it's just as rock solid, if not even better, for some cases, for some unique cases, in terms of Chromebooks. It's available as a Chrome web app as well as from the Play Store. That is, it's pretty much cross-platform, like the TeamViewer counterpart. Now, what you prefer to use will come down to personal preference, really. The Chrome Remote Desktop does require you to have an account, a Google account. If I remember correctly, yes, you need to use the web app, and you need to be logged in to actually use it, to actually utilize it. Last time I checked, so if I were to open a new incognito window and just say the same link, you would see that I need a Google account to actually utilize it, which is especially an inconvenience if you're trying to remote into a client system urgently. So I would say, if you're not within Google's ecosystem, or if you're not particularly keen to using Google's services, then you might find that an inconvenience. But provided that the majority of those that use the Chrome Remote Desktop in the first place are Chrome users as well as Chromebook users, then the need for the Google account is just considered the added security measure, or what you might consider the alternative to TeamViewers. TeamViewers, you know, PIN, usage of PIN, and etc. Because that's what alternative to Google's mandatory requirement for your email address, your Google email address, is TeamViewers PIN, request of PIN, which of course the Chrome Remote Desktop also require, right? But the email effectively adds a layer of security. So it depends from what perspective you're looking at it at. So if you're looking from a perspective of convenience, then TeamViewer wins. If you're looking from the perspective of an extra layer of security and the fact that it's completely free, then Chrome Remote Desktop wins, because the Chrome Remote Desktop is completely free, while the TeamViewer is only free for individual use, and you need to obtain a commercial license in order to benefit from the software on a large scale. Well, with that said, you can leave a comment down below on your thoughts. And one thing I did fail to mention was the fact that they both use the strong bit, they both use a strong encryption standard. But you could also argue that if you add the previous PIN code of an individual's system, right, and where a system was accessed illegally, right, and that code was used because it was already pre-saved in the TeamViewer app, right, then you could argue for that. I mean, you could argue for the fact that if an individual gets access to your system, they practically have control of the data and the applications. But the fact of the matter is that they both support strong encryption standards, which is the most important thing. It should be the highlight of this, which is effectively the highlight of this article, because the fact that your data is protected from the point of transmission to the point that it's been received from the other party is perhaps the most crucial thing to the effectiveness and usefulness of a remote desktop application. That being said, you can go ahead and view our written instruction on how to install them in the link down in the description below. And please do subscribe and hit the notification bell for more. Thank you.